Superalloys are a class of high-performance metallic materials that have been specifically engineered to endure high-stress environments while operating at ridiculously high temperatures, in some cases approaching 1,000 degrees Celsius. These materials really are marvels of metallurgy. Carefully selected alloying elements combine to create materials that can maintain strength and stability in the most extreme conditions, allowing us to push the boundaries of modern technology from highly reliable fasteners to jet engine turbine blades. Superalloys can be split into three distinct categories based on their main alloying element. Nickel-based superalloys are the most widely used, offering excellent mechanical properties and oxidation resistance at high operating temperatures. Cobalt-based superalloys have lower strength, but excel in applications involving rapid thermal cycling because of their excellent thermal fatigue resistance. And iron-based superalloys are a lower-cost alternative, suitable for less extreme applications. The most well-established of the nickel-based superalloys goes by the trade name Inconel, and was developed in the 1930s by the International Nickel Company, Inco. Several Inconel grades are available, with the most widely used being Inconel 718. It contains around 50% nickel, 20% chromium, 18% iron, refractory metals like niobium and molybdenum, and small amounts of titanium, aluminum, and a few other elements. L605 is a well-known cobalt-based superalloy, containing 50% cobalt, 20% chromium, 15% tungsten, and smaller amounts of nickel, iron, and other elements. And A286 is a stainless steel and well-known iron-based superalloy, made of 55% iron, 25% nickel, 15% chromium, and small amounts of other elements, including titanium and molybdenum. These carefully selected compositions give these materials incredible properties at high temperatures. Let's take a look at how the yield strengths of these superalloys and more conventional materials are affected by temperature, starting with Inconel 718. It has very high yield strength at room temperature, at around 1,200 megapascals, and its strength is remarkably stable as temperature increases, all the way up to around 700 degrees, where it begins to drop. This is the typical maximum operating limit for this alloy, although some other nickel-based superalloys retain useful strength at temperatures over 850 degrees. A286, an iron-based superalloy, and L605, a cobalt-based superalloy, have lower yield strengths than Inconel 718, but also do a really good job of preserving their strength at high temperatures. Some superalloys even show an increase in yield strength as temperature increases. This unusual behavior is called the yield strength anomaly. In any case, superalloys perform much better at high temperatures than more conventional materials. Titanium alloys, for example, have high strength at room temperature, but it drops gradually as temperature increases, making these materials unsuitable for very high temperature applications. Aluminum alloys have much lower strength, and aren't really suitable for use over 200 degrees. And the yield strength of 304 stainless steel decreases steadily with temperature, dropping to less than 50% of its room temperature value at 500 degrees. Another important factor to consider at elevated temperatures is creep, the slow, permanent deformation that occurs when a material is held under a sustained load over a long time period. Consider four bars made from different alloys. Each is loaded with a mass heavy enough to generate a uniform stress of 300 megapascals within it. When exposed to a temperature of 600 degrees, the bars begin to deform due to creep, which eventually leads to rupture. The four materials deform at very different rates. The 304 stainless steel bar ruptures first, after around 10 hours at 600 degrees. The titanium alloy bar is next, failing at around 30 hours. You would then need to wait 3.5 years for the A286 bar and 8 years for the Inconel 718 bar to fail. This illustrates just how good the mechanical properties of superalloys are in high temperature, high stress conditions. And they achieve this exceptional mechanical performance through their carefully engineered microstructures. Most superalloys are precipitation strengthened, meaning they contain a primary matrix phase that's reinforced by finely dispersed precipitates. These precipitates act as obstacles to the motion of dislocations, which enhances strength and also increases resistance to creep, which is mostly driven by the motion of dislocations. In Inconel 718, the matrix is mainly composed of nickel arranged in a face-centered cubic structure, which incorporates other alloying elements like chromium, molybdenum, and iron within the nickel structure as a solid solution, meaning they're uniformly distributed throughout the nickel, rather than forming separate phases. This is called the gamma phase. Embedded within this gamma matrix are the secondary gamma prime and gamma double prime precipitate phases. Of the two, it's the gamma double prime phase that contributes most to the strengthening of the alloy by providing an effective obstacle to the motion of dislocations. Each alloying element contributes in its own way to the high temperature properties of the superalloy. Nickel maintains its face-centered cubic microstructure right up to its melting point, resulting in a nickel-rich matrix that's very stable at high temperatures. It also readily incorporates other useful elements like iron or chromium into solid solution, which improves material strength. The use of refractory metals like niobium and molybdenum ensures good mechanical properties at high temperatures because these elements have very high melting points and excellent resistance to creep, with niobium crucially combining with nickel to form the gamma double prime phase. The presence of chromium in the matrix phase enhances corrosion resistance. It does this by forming a very thin chromium oxide film on the material surface, which acts as a protective shield and significantly enhances the alloy's resistance to corrosion. The layer grows thicker at higher temperatures, meaning the alloy's oxidation resistance can actually improve as conditions become more extreme. The chromium oxide layer is also self-healing. If disrupted, it rapidly reforms in the presence of oxygen. Superalloys are engineered for exceptional performance in environments where both high temperature and high mechanical stresses are present over long time periods. This makes them ideal materials for components like turbine blades and jet engines that need to endure extreme combustion temperatures and high mechanical stresses due to the high rotational speeds of the engine while also withstanding oxidation and corrosion. As the aerospace industry continuously pushes towards higher combustion temperatures to improve engine efficiency, meeting these demands is only possible with advanced superalloys that can operate under extreme thermal and mechanical stress. Superalloy turbine blades produced by conventional casting processes have a polycrystalline structure containing grain boundaries that can act as sites for creep deformation and crack initiation at high temperatures. This has led to the development of advanced manufacturing techniques that allow the superalloy to be cast as a single crystal, eliminating grain boundaries from the blade microstructure and significantly enhancing creep resistance and thermal fatigue performance. Other techniques like carefully designed internal cooling channels and thermal barrier coatings are used to push temperatures even higher. Superalloys, and the A286 alloy in particular, are also used extensively in high-performance fasteners. These fasteners are used in applications where high-temperature performance is critical because their high tensile strength and low stress relaxation properties allow them to maintain high clamping forces even after prolonged exposure to elevated temperatures. Despite their exceptional performance, the use of superalloys does come with some compromises. Material costs are high for one thing. Inconel 718 is up to 10 times more expensive than more conventional alloys. Superalloys can also be very difficult to machine. They tend to work hard and quickly, leading to rapid tool wear, the need for specialized tooling, and low cutting speeds, which further increases costs. And since they're mainly composed of heavy elements like nickel and cobalt, superalloys are significantly denser than aluminum or titanium alloys. This mass penalty and their high cost mean the use of superalloys is normally limited to situations where operating conditions are so extreme that no other material can do the job. In jet engine turbines, for example, superalloys are only used in the hottest sections immediately downstream of the combustion chamber to minimize the overall mass of the engine. Superalloys perfectly illustrate what makes material science so captivating. Their exceptional properties can be understood by looking closely at the internal structures that form within them, and this is true of countless other advanced materials. That's why this video is just the first in a new series I'm working on called Microstructure, where each episode explores a different type of material and reveals how its internal structure gives rise to astonishing and often seemingly impossible behaviors. The second episode dives into the world of shape memory alloys, remarkable metals that can remember a shape and snap back to it after having been deformed. And it's available right now over on Nebula. Nebula is an independent streaming site, built and owned by creators, that I've proudly been a part of for several years now. I post my videos early on Nebula, and it's where I'll be uploading more microstructure episodes in the coming months, exploring other interesting materials like high-entropy alloys, piezoelectric materials, ultralight alloys, and more. You won't find these episodes anywhere else. There's tons of original content on Nebula from other creators too. Bobby Broccoli has just released a fascinating feature-length documentary, 17 pages, that revisits one of the largest scientific controversies of the 20th century. Or you could try Abolish Everything, a hilarious comedy debate show where comedians battle it out in front of a live audience, each pleading the case to ban their pet peeve from society. There's plenty more high-quality content to watch on Nebula, and it's all completely ad-free. To get access to my Microstructure series and everything else that Nebula has to offer, head over to go.nebula.tv/theefficientengineer. Signing up using this link will give you a 40% discount off the annual subscription, so it'll cost you just $3 a month or $36 a year. Subscribing to Nebula is the best way to directly support this channel and helps me make more videos like this one. And that's it for this look at superalloys. Thanks for watching.